Today I'm going to show you how to create a fillable form in Word for Mac that contains form fields like text boxes, drop-down lists, and checkboxes. I'm also going to show you how you can change the options of your form fields so you can do things like limiting the maximum character limit and forcing date field formatting. First, I'm going to show you how to build the form template from scratch with tables and section headers. But if you already have a form template ready, I'm going to include timestamps in the description below so you can jump to the parts of the video where we start inserting and programming our form fields. Let's get started. Before we begin, I'm working with Mac OS Monterey version 12.2.1, and I have the latest updates for Microsoft 365. I also have my developer tab enabled on my ribbon. If you don't already have your developer tab enabled, you're going to want to go up to Word, Preferences, click on the ribbon and toolbar. On the right-hand side, under Customize the Ribbon, Main Tabs, make sure that you have Developer checked and click Save. Then you can close out of your Word preferences and you'll see the Developer tab up at top. That's where all of our form fields will be when we start to create our form. Now let's open a new document and start to build out our form. We're going to start with our header. I'm going to select it. We'll center it, make it bold, and increase the font size. I'll hit enter, select the cursor, bring it back over to the left, unbold, and bring down the font size. Next, we want to include an area for the name and date of the incident that we're capturing, but instead of just typing text followed by an underscore to create this, we want to create an area for the form fields that won't shift when the user starts typing it. So to do this, we're going to create a table with only the bottom borders that we want underlined. Let's go up to Insert, Table, and I'm going to select one row, three columns. Now the middle column is just going to be a spacer, so we'll adjust that in by dragging the cells. And here I'm going to type name and date. Now I'm going to select my table and I want to take away the borders. I'm going to come up to borders and click on no borders. Now what I want to do is select only the cells where I want the underline. So I'm going to hold my Command key and select the other cell. We'll go back up to borders and select bottom border. Now we'll be able to put a form field here and the user can type in without having this line shift. Next, let's create our section headers. This form is going to include sections for incident location, type of incident, and the description of the incident. Let's select these and make them bold. I'm going to hold my Command key while clicking. Then I'm going to come up, make them bold, and increase the font size. Now what we're going to do is select the top section header, and we're going to go up to Insert. We'll go to Table and click on Convert Text to Table. We'll leave one column by one row and click OK. Then what we want to do is take away the border. So we'll say no border. And add a fill color. Now if we want, we can go back and add a bottom border. So we can go back to borders and we can say bottom border. Now we can repeat this for the other two section headers. I'll speed up this section of the video to save time since the other headings are done exactly the same way as the incident location section. Okay, in the incident location section, we're going to add a table for our drop-down selections for the region, state, and city. So let's place our cursor where we want to insert that table. We'll go up to Insert, select Table. We're going to select two rows with three columns. Then we can insert our headers, region, state, and city. We can format the header row by selecting it. We can make it bold and select a fill color. And we can center align it. Then if we want to, we can drag the bottom cell down to make the cell a little bit larger where we're going to place our drop-down list selections. In the type of incident section, we're going to add checkboxes for injury, illness, and environment. Then finally, we have one large area where we can place our description of the incident, so we're going to just insert a table with one cell, and that'll be a large box area that we can adjust to fit on the page. This will expand when we put the text form field in it. Now that we have our form template in place, let's start adding our form fields. Go ahead and place your cursor back up here next to name. I'm going to hit space twice. Then I'm going to come up to my developer tab. I'm going to click on the text box. And then I'm going to do the same thing over here at date. We're going to place our cursor where we want to insert the text box, go up to the developer tab and click on text box. Now, if we want to make some adjustments to the options of these form fields, like if we want to put a character limit in how many characters and spaces that a user can type into the field, double click on the name field, it'll open up the text form field options. Notice that the maximum length is defaulted to unlimited. We can select that and put a length. So we can say 20 characters as an example. I can then click OK. For date, I can force date field formatting if I want the date to display in a specific format. All I have to do is double click to open up the text form field options. And instead of regular text, I can select a type of date. And then under the date format, I can drop down and select the date format that I want to enforce. Let's say I want to have the year, month, and day. Then I can click OK. Now I want to include my drop-down list selections. I'm going to place my cursor in the cell for region, and then I'm going to come up to the developer tab and click on combo box. This inserts another form field that looks similar to a text box, but if you double click to open the options, you'll notice that we can program the drop-down list items. The first item I'm going to input is please select, because this item is going to show when the form field is blank. So I'm just going to put please select, and this will prompt the user to click on that box and select an item from the drop-down list. And so my items will be north and south. When I'm done entering my selections, I can click OK. Notice if you need to, you can use the arrow buttons to move items up and down, and then click OK. I'm going to repeat that step for the state and city. We'll place our cursor, select a combo box, and enter our state options. I'm going to add please select, then I'll hit enter to add it, and then I'm going to type Maine, Massachusetts, Georgia, Florida, and hit OK. Now for the city, go up to add the combo box, enter please select, Portland, Boston, Atlanta, and Miami, then hit OK. Now if I want to, I can realign where those sit within those cells. I can select that cell, hit my control button and click. Then I can go to cell alignment and say align center left, and that will place those in the middle of my expanded cells. Next, I want to place checkboxes in the type of incident. So I'm going to place my cursor again where I want to put a checkbox, then just go up to the developer tab and click on checkbox and hit a few spaces. And then I just repeat that wherever I want to insert my checkboxes. Then I can adjust the spacing in between if I want to add a little bit of space. I can hit enter, go home, and size this down just so there's a little bit of space in between each option. And finally, in the description of incident, I just want to place a regular text box. I can go back up to the developer tab and then insert a text box. So when users type in here, they'll have an unlimited amount of space to type in, and the cell will expand automatically for them. Now, one quick icon I wanted to point out to you that's up here on the developer tab is this shading button. If you click it, notice that all of the form fields, the gray shading disappears. So if you're going to print your form, you may want to come up and click on the shading button to turn it off. And then if you want to, you can leave it on so that users will know where those form fields are. When you're ready, you can protect your form. This will lock your form so that users will only be able to click in the form field areas and fill them in. Let's go ahead and protect our form and save our document. We'll go to File, Save As, and save where you want to save your form. Now let's test out our form field. We had put a 20 character maximum limit here in the name area. So if we start typing, we notice that once we hit 20 characters and spaces, we're not able to keep typing. So that limit is enforced. Also, if we come over here to the date field and type in a date and hit tab, notice that the formatting that we selected was enforced. We can go down to our drop-down lists and make our selections. And we can check our checkboxes. Then we can also type in our description of incident. Now notice that this is bold. If we don't want to have this bold, we can back it out and come back up and unprotect our form, and we can make edits. So we want to select this form field, come back up to the Home tab, uncheck bold, and move the font size back down. Now we can go back and test our form again, protect it, and now when we type in, we'll have the updated formatting. Now once you're ready, you can clear out the contents that you've used to test your form and resave it. And now you're ready to distribute your form. Be sure and check out the playlist on my channel for more tutorials on how to create fillable forms. Visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.